It was a crazy time. My life changed so much, so fast. We released Royals at the end of 2012, and by the middle of 2013, it was basically the biggest song in the world. You can call me Queen Bee. And it was number one in the States for over 2 months. That is the craziest 6 months of my life.
Pure Heroin was so huge. You know, we sold 8 million records. It was just phenomenal. And when you've had that level of success, everything changes.
When you're making your first record, the pressure comes from you and within. If that first record goes on to become really popular, you can't escape whatever has been generated by your first album. You can never start with that clean slate again.
Okay, I can't really do that thing I just used to do that came naturally to me. That won't feel fresh. It has to be a complete right turn. I went out and I played a lot of shows, and it gave me a sense of the actual physicality of music. You know, I'd been making music in a tiny little room and not giving too much thought to people's bodies moving to it. You know, you can't really dance to Royals. So I knew that whatever I made next would have that kinetic feeling to it. You know, bodies pushing up against each other and jumping. But I hear sounds in my mind. Greenlight, they ended up being this totally rammed pop song, this treasure box of all these memories and moments and colors laid on top of each other, you know. It's wild.
Start bouncing that way.
I hear the opening of my world in this song. I had never been anywhere when I wrote Royals, and this sounds like somebody who's seen everything and is just trying to find a way to get through, you know?
Ella had such a strong sense about who she was and where she wanted to go. And that is incredibly rare, to see someone so young, so focused, and such vision about where she was going. The smartest decision we made was actually standing aside, putting out all our energy behind her just to support her vision.
A successful international music career comes down to your music and what it says. Are you able to articulate what you mean, and does what you mean have a resonance?
And this is the piano part that we worked for months and months on, 20 pianos trying to get the right janky French hall sound on. I was just had such a specific tone in mind. So I would be like, we've stumbled on an old hall in the French countryside, and there's a piano in there, and someone starts playing it, and that's what it's going to sound like. I think we got there. I think it really does sound like it's coming from a hall somewhere. There's a lot of ups and downs of emotion in the song. The second verse is very like, I don't even care. I'm moving on, it's all good. And then the second pre is where the missing of somebody really floods back in. And I wanted to communicate that with what I was calling the forest when we were working on it, which is just like a collection of different synths and like bells and things that we would hit. And this is like my favorite part of the song, but it's like something that no one would ever even hear. Listen to this, it's so cool. This is the sad, the forest. Maybe I made a mistake, you know, it's all those when all the doubt is creeping in, and all the emotion. And then you just snap it back. With Royals, that song is so simple. I was like a hyper minimalist. For Greenlight, it was really more maximal. There's these bizarre changes in tone, chord-wise. There's a lot of ideas production-wise that I wanted to get in there, and there are a lot of emotional shifts, and it all had to kind of fit into under 4 minutes. And then it's guitar. Really emotional. That's the perfect thing to me, is that happiness and sadness. I am really proud of the tone that I've set when I'm making music. I love collaborating, but it's my experience. They're my memories, you know, and it's about honoring those and painting them in the colors that I want to paint them in. I can hear every stage that I've been on, everything that's happened to me in 5 years, you know, and there's a triumph to it, and that makes me happy.
To actually break and be a big star internationally, you just need something very, very special. Only a few New Zealand acts make it.
I love that physicality and that kinetic energy totally translated. This sea of people jumping up and down and screaming and crying and losing their minds. That is the high point of my show. I'm so happy that people got it.